Hey, it's your girl, Chill Ms. Jackson from Urban Vibes Radio. I'm here at BMG Studios with the Antoine Amadeus Thompson, Platinum Boy Music CEO, also a bad boy hitman, correct? Still, for many years now, correct?
Quite a few.
We don't want to age you. We don't want to. Well, you're looking good. Well, all right. Here tonight, though, at BMG, you held a special. It was called The Session.
It's a sit down. Is what it's called, and just an opportunity for artists and producers and songwriters to be seen and heard. Mm-hmm. You know, there's a lot of inspiring musicians that would love to be in the position I'm in, or higher position I'm in. You know what I'm saying? That I'm in, and you know, I want to just reach out to them, show love, listen to them, help them if needed, give them the information that they need to move forward and to become better and greater as an artist and a musician. And that's why we kind of created, you know, the platform. So it's definitely been a great night. I heard about 7 or 8 artists tonight. So we definitely had a great turnout. Definitely excited about the turnout that we had, and looking forward to the next one.
Is this the first one you've held, or have you held others?
No, this is probably about the 4th, 5th, or 6th, maybe. Yes, we've had a few. I try to do one once a month. If you know my schedule allows and I'm not on the road, I try to do it.
And if a young artist is interested in coming to one of these sessions, how do they hook themselves up with that?
Well, you can follow me on Instagram. Amadeus PBM is the name. And normally I post a flyer a lot, promoting the event, promoting the date, and there's an email address on it, Platinum Boy Music Consultation. Thank you, sis. PlatinumBoyMusicConsultation@gmail.com. That's the email. And like I said, we'll be posting whenever the next sit down will be. And artists can kind of just stay tuned and post it to the page, get the new date, sign up, register, and hopefully, you know, we'll be a part of the next session.
Very nice. Now, I'll write a little bit about your history, where you came from. You started out, you picked up your calling from within the church, from what I have read, and you felt that your calling was percussion. How did you make the progression from percussion to production?
Great question. You know, first I wanted to be an artist, and some people know the story, some people don't. Thought I was gonna be a rapper. Didn't really work out too good, but I was always a musician, and just had, you know, was surrounded by different people that were already in the business that encouraged me to go behind the scenes and be a creative person, you know what I'm saying? And I kind of took their advice, glad I did. One of the best decisions I've ever made. I love music, I love drums, I love instrumentation. So to be considered as, you know, a great producer and musician amongst myself and my colleagues, you know, I'm definitely appreciative of that. So yeah, it definitely started in church. Church is where you can just do whatever you want to do. You know what I'm saying? Like, there's no rules, just kind of, you know, as we would say, allow the Lord to use us and use our gift. And that's where it started. So from playing in school and playing in church, you know, I've been blessed to be able to tour the world, you know, using my gift as a musician and as a drummer. And them same drums I, you know, banged on once at school is, you know, in Africa and Japan and Australia and in Europe. And, you know, it's just a blessing.
There's a beautiful thing, I think, what you do with Music 101. And there's 4 parts to that. Educate,
yes.
Empower,
okay.
Inspire,
okay.
And transform.
No one has ever said that besides the team.
Well, I had to do my homework.
She didn't. She say it again. I know we live. She just did something monumental. She just shared something with me, and only we have said this. So this is the first person besides us to say it. Can you explain? Can you just say, repeat what you just did?
There's 4 pieces to the formula of Music 101. It's educate, empower, inspire, and transform. Well, of course I did. I'm a journalist. I had to do my homework.
So we live. Get it, girl. Spot. We live on the spot. We live. You're getting this live.
That's good.
That's
amazing.
Amazing.
That's amazing.
That's amazing.
I'm glad you did it. I already knew it, man.
Amazing. We had to stop. We had to pause. We had to pause and consider and give her her moment. Yes. Yeah. Amazing job. Amazing.
Well, thank you. Thank you.
That's how you close the night, goddamn.
All right. Well, yes. And I think that it's a beautiful formula. I see you from looking at your past. You're someone that had a lot of family support. Yes. You had a strong family unit.
Sort of. Let's talk about that. You know, my parents, you know, grew up in the church, church space. So at first they weren't really supportive of what I was doing because they didn't understand it. No. You know, they weren't really big hip hop fans. They didn't like the profanity. And I had to explain to them, like, listen, Ma, I don't rap. I just make the music. So whatever an artist says on top of the song or the beat I created, I have nothing to do with that. So once I established that part, it was a little cool. And a life-changing moment for me was my mom watching MTV Cribs. And she saw Swiss Beats on there, and the mansion that he had. And he bought his mother like a Benz or something. And she kind of like comes walking in my room, and she's like, yeah, so I just watched Swizzle. I said, what? That's why Swizzle, somebody named Swizzle, and he was on MTV Cribs, and he got like a mansion, and he was saying that he make beats. Is that what you do? I said, yes, Mom. And she was like, oh, well, good. And I was like, so it's cool now. And she's like, yeah, you should have been told me. I said, I was trying to tell you that a long time ago. You know, so, you know, now they have an understanding of what it is, they're supportive. And it's been a cool journey. You know what I mean? My mom's being proud of me being on TV or touring, and you know, that's my boy, that's my son, you know what I mean? So it's an amazing feeling. And, you know, me having a son now, he's actually turning 11 on Wednesday, and we celebrated his life today, the whole weekend, basically. You know, I want to make sure I give him that support and encouragement he needs, knowing what I lacked growing up. You know, whatever you lack growing up, your children shouldn't lack the same thing, because you should say, okay, well, I know what that felt like. And I didn't like it, it didn't feel good, so I want to see to it that he doesn't go through what I went through, you know. So he's in DJ classes right now, like, he's playing drums, and he's doing basketball, and he's doing football. Like, just do everything, and we'll figure out what you're passionate about and what you love, and we'll support you in that. Whether it's a musician or not, he may not want to be a musician. He told me he wants to be a pilot. I'm not a pilot, you know, so, but if that's what you want to be, you know, he'll have my support 100%.
You're gonna get behind that. I think what I look at too is like reading about your story and how your parents kept you away from certain elements, you know, in the streets. They were, you know, strict about that and firm about keeping you away from that. I see a lot of kids that don't have that. But a lot of kids look at rap or music as a way out, but not everybody's gonna make it. You know, but how far out of reach is this where you're at now? You know, how far of this was hard work? How much of this was luck? And what do you suggest to young men, whether they have that kind of support or not, and women, you know, how to get to where you are, or even halfway to where you are?
Like you said, just, you know, a lot of hard work and dedication, you know, being denied, but not accepting being denied. You know, me continuing to do this, to do what I do today, is because of the love and the passion of creating music. If I didn't love it, if I wasn't passionate about it, I would have gave up a long time ago. You know, the amount of people that said no to me and no to the team that, you know, wouldn't help, that sort of talent, sort of gift, but still wouldn't invest in it. You know what I'm saying? Like, all of that was motivation to pursue it even more. Like, I know, you know, I have something special, and it's not about being cocky or, you know what I mean, conceited. It's just knowing that, you know, like I said, God gave us all gifts. You know, I recognize mine. I know what it is. I know what my calling is, and I'm walking in it. You know, if you don't recognize yours or recognize your calling, you know, that's whose fault is that? You know what I mean? You can't be mad at me for knowing God said I can be great. You know, so it's just about sharing with the world that you can be great too in your own right. And being great has nothing to do with my greatness. Like, don't compare us. You know, I can't compare myself to Kanye. I can't compare myself, you know, to Puff Daddy. You know, I'm inspired by them. You know, Jay-Z and Kevin Lyles, you know, Trey Songz. You know, these are people that are doing greater things and that are on a different level somewhat from me. Level of what the world would consider success. You know, success to me is waking up and seeing my son smile. You know what I'm saying? And knowing that if he's hungry, he can go open up the refrigerator and eat. you know, or if he's cold, I can turn the heat on in the house. You know what I'm saying? It's little things like that that are so big to me, and that's success to me. So, you know, it's about going for your dreams. We all have dreams, and why not live them? You know, don't wake up every day doing something you hate. It's like, you know, be brave, step out on faith, and say, hey, I'm not going to do that no more. I'm going to go this way because this is what I love to do. You're going to lose friends. You're going to lose family. You're going to lose finances. You know, you may not have the support you need, but, you know, those are all excuses. Like, I know what that feels like. You know what I'm saying? And I still have so much more work to do. But I believe. And that's the key, believing in yourself and not allowing anyone to tell you no and going to get that. Put that work in. You know?
Got to work at it. I want to say thank you because it's been a long night for you and everybody here. Yes. But, yeah, but you were in there doing the work. We were out here just hoping for our moment, you know, to get to sit with you. Definitely, you deserve all the success that's come to you. Being in your presence, there's a lot of genuineness about you. And I believe everything that you're saying, you believe in yourself, but you believe in the music and you believe in the message that you're bringing. So, thank you.
Thank you.
Amadeus.
Say your name.
I'm Chill Miss Jackson. Chill Miss Jackson signing out.
Shout out to Chill Miss Jackson. Great interview. She's on point. Look out for her. She's coming after everything. Chill Miss Jackson. You heard?
Thank you.
I like girls with gold teeth. Faithful, don't cheat. Let me handcuff her to the bed like police. Too real for Twitter. Man, she's so street. Check her timeline. You won't see no tweets. Ride or die chick. You don't want no beef. Good sense of humor. She funny like Monique. She a neat freak. The crib be so neat. A night freak. Swear to God, I don't get no sleep. Ahead, cause we both getting bread. Whole week. Disagree, we gon' patch it up. Slow leak. Watch Kevin Hart. He had me so weak. Seen Cooley High. We cry for cold cheeks. Eating mangoes in the summer. So sweet. We be riding on them jet skis, Jones Beach. Strong like 40 kings and queens, we both beasts. Even though it's just two of us,
this
we roll deep.
This is power, this is pride. King and queen, so divine. If love can kill, it'll be a homicide. No describing this thing we got. Ain't nothing like black love.